Hello everyone and welcome back to Easy Dentistry, a channel that makes dental education incredibly easy and interesting. We have started uploading lectures on the bacterial infections of the oral cavity. Today's lecture is on leprosy, which is also called as the Hansen's disease. Before we begin this important lecture on leprosy, subscribe to our channel if you have not yet done. Share these lectures with all your friends and share knowledge. Do comment and let us know your feedback. And also, if you like the lecture, don't forget to put on the thumb icon. So, starting with leprosy, the introduction. Leprosy is a chronic granulomatous infection caused by Mycobacterium leprae. So, the causative organism is Mycobacterium leprae. And it multiplies very slowly. The incubation period of this organism is 5 years. So remember here, the incubation period of the causative organism Mycobacterium leprae is 5 years. Now, symptoms may occur even after 20 years of infection. The disease is contagious and it affects the skin, peripheral nerves, upper respiratory tract, eyes, testicles, muscles, bones, and joints. If untreated, leprosy can cause permanent deformity in the patient, and recently multi-drug therapy has proved to be quite effective against leprosy. Now, talking in detail about the etiological organism, Mycobacterium leprae is an obligate intracellular organism, acid-fast bacilli, and it is gram-positive, it is acid-fast, and it infects the peripheral nerves. It exhibits a unique DOPA oxidase activity. It has acid-fast nature and it replicates in the cooler tissues of the body like the skin, peripheral nerves, the respiratory tract, eyes and testes. So remember, Mycobacterium leprae, it replicates in the cooler tissues of the body. We can demonstrate Mycobacterium leprae in smears stained by ZN stain. In this ZN stain, the living bacilli appear as pink solid rods, while the non-living appear as granular and fragmented. Culture of Mycobacterium leprae can be done on mouse footpad and nine-banded armadillo. And this culture can be done at a temperature of 30 to 33 degrees Celsius with a doubling time of 12 days. And this organism remain viable for around 10 days. Now, remember an important point, the age of occurrence of leprosy is bimodal. So, there is bimodal age distribution, peak at 10 to 14 years and then again at 35 to 44 years. The mode of infection is not known, but the probable spread is through the nasal secretion. Now, the pathogenesis of leprosy, the immunologic and epidemiologic studies suggest most people have a subclinical infection and very few develop infection. Once infected, both the cell-mediated and the humoral immunity comes into play, and this immune response are elicited by the bacterial antigen DNA glycolipids. Now remember here, lipoarabinomenan, a component of the cell membrane of Mycobacterium leprae, it induces an immune response by inhibiting or reducing the interferon gamma mediated activation of macrophages, and all this ultimately leads to immune suppression. So remember, the component of the cell membrane of Mycobacterium leprae, the arabinomenan, is responsible for the immune suppression. Now, the bacteria are taken up in the body by the histiocytes in the skin and the Schwann cells in the nerves. Now, the inflammatory response to this bacteria is in the form of histiocytes and the lymphocytes. Now, leprosy has a diverse clinical spectrum. There are two types, tuberculoid leprosy and the lepromatous leprosy, and an intermediate type of leprosy too. The tuberculoid leprosy has an intense cell-mediated immune response, but this disease has a low bacillary count, while the lepromatous leprosy has low cell-mediated immune response but a very high bacillary count. The intermediate type of leprosy shows hypopigmented erythematous papules on the skin. Now, the clinical features. The patients may develop hypopigmented patches and there may be a partial or total loss of cutaneous sensation. The first sensation to be lost is the sensation of light touch. There is thickening of the nerves and acid-fast bacilli can be demonstrated in the smears from the lesion. The tuberculoid lesions of leprosy may appear as single or multiple macular erythematous lesions in dermal or peripheral nerves. So, this is a classic lesion of tuberculoid type of leprosy. There is loss of sensation and loss of sweating of the patient. Lepromatous lesions of leprosy shows erythematous macules or papules. There may be thickening of the skin. Nodules appear on the skin resulting into disfigurement. So here you can see the lesions of lepromatous leprosy. The nodules are present on the skin. Facial paralysis is a common symptom showing also lumps in the skin, plantar ulcers, loss of fingers and toes, nasal depression, foot drop and claw toe are other symptoms. Oral manifestations. Tumor-like masses may occur in the oral cavity of leprosy patients and these are called as the lepromas. These lepromas mostly occur on the tongue, lips, heart palate, and with subsequent trauma, these lepromas may ulcerate. There may also occur gingival hyperplasia and loosening of teeth. So, here you can see the classic leproma lesion on the heart palate of the leprosy patient. Now, the histologic picture of leprosy lesion shows granulomatous nodule composed of epitheloid histiocytes, lymphocytes in fibrous stroma. There may be Langhans type of giant cells present invariably. Sheets of lymphocytes are present with vacuolated macrophages called as the lepra cells. So here you can see the histologic findings of leprosy, in which you can see the foam cells or the lepra cells present in the dermis. And here is the microscopic picture where you can appreciate numerous foamy macrophages. These foamy macrophages contain the acid-fast bacilli. Now, as we have already discussed, tuberculoid leprosy shows a decreased organism count, while lepromatous leprosy has a higher organism count in the lesions. Now the diagnosis. M. leprae can be cultured from the foot pads of mice and armadillos. Nasal smear scrapings on ZN stain may show acid fast bacilli in a concentration of higher than 10 to the power 11 gram of tissue. Now, there is something called as the morphologic index. The morphologic index is a measure of the number of acid-fast bacilli in the skin scraping that stain uniformly bright and those bacilli which are viable. So, this is called as the morphologic index. The number of acid-fast bacilli that stain brightly and are viable. And there is something called as bacteriologic index. This is a logarithmic scaled measure of density of M. leprae in the dermis, maybe as high as 40 to 60 in untreated patient, and this count it reduces by 1 unit per year if effective therapy is given to the patient. So remember these two, what is morphologic index and what is the bacteriologic index of the patient. Now, diagnosis can be done by skin biopsy, nerve biopsy or food culture histamine test. Sorry, here it should be food, not food. Food culture histamine test. Now, the tests to elicit the humoral response by the patient are the monoclonal antibody test, ELISA and PCR. While in children, the sweat function test can also be used to determine the humoral response. Now, points to remember in leprosy, the causative organism, M. leprae, the incubation period, 5 years, it is an acid-fast bacilli, and there is characteristic presence of lepra cells or the foamy macrophages in the lesion. The characteristic DOPA oxidase activity of M. leprae. The bimodal age distribution of leprosy at 10 to 14 years and then again at 35 to 44 years. The component of the cell membrane of M. leprae, the lipoarabinominan, which reduces the immunity of the patient. So here we complete with the lecture on leprosy. Next lecture will be on actinomycosis, which is another important topic of oral pathology. If you don't want to miss it, please subscribe to our channel. Thanks for watching.